Good evening, students. Today we will learn structure of diborane. Actually, structure of diborane. So, what is the molecular formula of diborane? So, diborane is B2H6. So, it is similar to C2H6. And you know what is C2H6? It is ethane. C2H6 is ethane. But when we talk about ethane, in ethane we have two CH3 units. And these two CH3 units, each carbon is left with one electron. Because carbon has
four
electrons. So out of four, three are involved in bonding with hydrogens, and each carbon left with one electron, and that form a bond with each other. So there are four sigma bonds by each carbon. So it is two center, two electron bond. Each bond is two center, two electron bond. Now, if same reference, we draw the structure of diborane. You know, it looks like there are two BH3 units. So one BH3 is like this, other BH3. But now, each boron has how many electrons?
Three
electrons are involved in bonding with hydrogens. No electron is free, or no electron is there on each boron. So this type of structure is not formed for B2S6. Clear? So it is actually electron deficient compound. And you know, ethane is electron precise compound. Each carbon has 8 electrons. Clear? But here, each boron has 3 its own and 3 are shared. So, 6 electrons. So, there is no electron left between two borons. Clear? That means its structure is not similar to ethane. Clear? Now, next part is, what is electronic configuration of boron? It is 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. So 2s2 and 2p1. So in ground state, boron has one unpaired electron. Now in excited state, one of the electron from 2s is shifted to 2p. Now how many valence electrons are there? 3. So it can form 3 normal bonds. But if we form 3 normal bonds, diborane is not satisfied. There is no bond between two boron atoms. That means this vacant orbital is also involved in bonding. And structure is, each boron involves all the 4 orbitals, 1s and 3 2p. That means each boron is sp3 hybridized, and boron has 3 orbitals with 1 unpaired electron and 1 orbital is vacant. So these 4 orbitals, 3 are normal with 1 unpaired electron and 1 is vacant. Now second boron is of same type. Now this orbital of boron having 1 electron overlap simultaneously with vacant orbital of other boron, with 1s orbital of hydrogen. That means boron, two borons have one sp3 hybrid orbital which has one electron, other sp3 hybridized orbital which is vacant, they overlap simultaneously with 1s orbital of hydrogen, and such bond is known as 3 center. And how many electrons are involved? 2. One from this boron and other from hydrogen. So this is called 3 center 2 electron bond. Same in the case here, one boron with vacant orbital overlap with other orbital of second boron simultaneously with 1s orbital of hydrogen. Now we left with two orbitals and they overlap with 1s orbital of hydrogen. These terminal bonds are two center, two electron bonds, but these bonds are 3 center, 2 electron bonds. Clear? DH2, BH2, in between that it is like this, this is electron cloud, clear, two borons and hydrogen attached to each other, clear, and this is also known as banana bond, good, this is 3 center, 2 electron bond or banana bond. Okay, these two hydrogens are known as terminal hydrogens. Again, terminal hydrogens, and in between them, these are called bridging hydrogens. Now, this BH2, this BH2, they are in the same plane. But these two hydrogens, bridging hydrogen, one is above the plane, other is below the plane. Clear? So this is overall non-planar molecule in which each boron is sp3 hybridized. Okay? Thank you.